Hello. In this video, we will see carbon dioxide dissociation curve. First, we will quickly see some relevant points, and then we will see the curve itself. Let's get started. In video of transport of carbon dioxide, we have seen that carbon dioxide is produced at peripheral sites during metabolism. This carbon dioxide diffuses into the blood and takes various forms. It is transported in these forms. Now, if partial pressure of carbon dioxide increases, quantity of all these products also increase. Carbon dioxide dissociation curve shows the relationship between partial pressure of carbon dioxide and total carbon dioxide content of blood in all these forms. Let's see the curve now. Here, x-axis shows partial pressure of carbon dioxide. And y-axis shows total carbon dioxide content in all the forms. The curve looks like this. As partial pressure of carbon dioxide increases, its total content in blood also increases. At peripheral tissues, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is about 46 mmHg. Due to higher partial pressure, carbon dioxide enters into the blood. This value of partial pressure corresponds to this point in the curve. At this point, total content of carbon dioxide is about 52 ml carbon dioxide in 100 ml of blood. Thus, carbon dioxide content in venous blood is about 52 ml per 100 ml blood. Now, this blood reaches to the lungs. Here, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is about 40 mmHg. Due to lower partial pressure, carbon dioxide diffuses from blood into the lungs. It corresponds to this point in the curve. Here, carbon dioxide content is about 50 ml carbon dioxide in each 100 ml of blood. If this were the only thing that happens, arterial blood would contain 50 ml carbon dioxide per 100 ml blood. And that would mean only 2 ml carbon dioxide is offloaded at lungs. But something more also happens on top of this simple transport. I am talking about Haldane's effect. I have ignored it in this discussion to develop the basic understanding first. I think you know the basics now. So in next video, we will see Haldane's effect. That's it for this video. If you struggle understanding medical concepts, your search might end here. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Watch more videos and you will know it. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.